Here on the West Coast, we hear a lot about tsunamis. As we know from recent events in Japan and Southeast Asia, tsunamis can be incredibly destructive. So what exactly are tsunamis, and where do they come from?
A tsunami is what we refer to as a body wave. It affects the entire water column in an ocean or a lake. It essentially is a wave phenomenon in that energy is propagated away from a source. I kind of, because they've been so destructive, refer to them as stealth killers.
The seismic ones generated by earthquakes, when you displace the bottom. Off Sumatra in 2004, that huge tsunami that was generated there was displacements of 5 to 10 meters in the bottom, where suddenly the bottom goes up on one side and down on the other. And all that water, 2,000 meters of water, is displaced. Huge waves are generated. So that's earthquake-generated tsunamis, seismically-generated tsunamis. They happen everywhere in the world. The other kind are landslide-generated tsunamis. So a failure of the coastline or some kind of a big slump that fails and it pushes the water ahead of it as it fails, or a mountain falls into the water.
But about 80% of the big tsunamis in the world are generated in the Pacific Ocean. And the reason that tsunamis occur in these environments is that's where big earthquakes occur, along the Pacific Ring of Fire. It's called that because these earthquakes are also associated with active volcanoes. We get these very explosive, fiery eruptions that occur because these plates are in contact with one another and generating the forces that can create both earthquakes and volcanic eruptions.
The speed of a tsunami is basically set by the depth of the ocean. So if we use an average depth of the ocean, about 5 kilometers, it's basically the speed of a jet. So that's 700, 800 kilometers per hour.
You're on an aircraft coming from Japan, for example, towards Canada during the 2011 Japanese tsunami. Your jet plane would just be able to keep up with that wave as it crossed the ocean. It took it 9 hours and 57 minutes to get to Bamfield on the west coast of Vancouver Island.
So this massive wave can move at the speed of a jet. What are the odds of a tsunami landing here? And if one does, what should we do?
The likelihood of a tsunami coming to Vancouver Island is actually very good. We live in a very seismically active region, and so we're at a high risk of tsunamis. So any large Pacific-based earthquake could cause a tsunami, which could impact British Columbia's Pacific coast.
We have developed, with Rick Thompson, very, very precise sensors on the bottom of the ocean that actually measure the actual pressure of the water, which is really equivalent to the height. And we can precisely measure to sub-millimeter detail in 3 kilometers of water how high that wave is. And so with those sensors, we can then begin to use models to predict the speed and direction and the height of the wave that will impact our coast. If there is a megathrust earthquake off our coast, we will have a major tsunami, and we want to be able to provide much more direct warning. Now, we wouldn't be doing this directly. We have to work with our emergency management teams here in British Columbia, but that's the direction we want to go in.
The information and data that's collected from Ocean Networks Canada helps emergency managers to understand what kind of a tsunami might be coming in any given time.
We have the ability, with the technology we have, to do an early detection of an earthquake when it first hits. We may be able to give places in Vancouver and Victoria a 30 to 40 second warning of major ground shaking hitting. That's a lot. People say, well, that's not very much, but it can turn a valve off, it can stop trains, it can set off an alarm in schools. So there's many things we could do with that. So we're working with a team of people in British Columbia over a 5-year time period to see if we can implement something like that.
I think the most important thing about tsunamis is understanding your risks, where you live, where you work, and where you play. So if you're traveling to an area that has tsunami risk, to understand that there is a tsunami risk, and then to understand what actions you would take to keep yourself safe in the event of a tsunami.
If you're walking the beaches in Tofino, and there's a big earthquake, don't even wait for any warning. Just go to higher ground, because you're gonna have about a half an hour, at most 3/4 of an hour. Before the tsunami hits, and it's going to be big on the outer coast.
Today we had a chance to learn more about tsunamis. Thanks to the team at Ocean Networks Canada, and thanks to you for being part of our ongoing explorations here at Ocean Alive.